that I am a spokesperson for the company. It's super cool, man. I've been doing Rubik's Cube since I was a little kid, and so now to be in a position where, you know, I can actually benefit the company in some way, it's super exciting. My teammates here at the Broncos, I think, are just now starting to find out about this interesting little, I don't know what you call it, talent. All through college, all through my time with the Jets and the Patriots, it's like something that I do that relaxes me. Before a game, you're trying to get mentally dialed into whatever your assignments are, and, you know, being an offensive lineman, there's a lot of things you gotta be keen to, and you gotta be ready to protect Joe, obviously, in our offense. You know, the Rubik's Cube has always helped me, you know, dial in, get rid of distractions, and kind of stimulate my mind before the game so I can be ready to think at an elite level.
What does it take to solve a Rubik's Cube?
So funny, the first thing I'll say that it takes is patience. I think for me, especially when I was first trying to do it, you know, you want to jump ahead a bunch of steps. You don't want to take the time or be diligent. For a guy who was good with numbers, I was a mathematical economics major. Math and numbers have always come easy to me. Then you can think about it, at least conceptually, that you're putting together a Sudoku puzzle in your head. And then the spatial awareness and all that, and that, the hand movements are just things you train over time.
Do they call you Rain Man?
I haven't gotten Rain Man yet, but that's a delightful first. There's many ways you can challenge your mind to think different or to comprehend things differently. I think it just expands your overall knowledge and ability to comprehend and understand things.